In today's demo, I'm going to show you how to sync records from ServiceNow into Smartsheet. For my use case, you could imagine that we're dispatching tasks or assignments from ServiceNow into Smartsheet. So I'll just go ahead and show you the Unito Flow Builder. So this is where we'll be building the connection between Smartsheet and ServiceNow in just a few minutes. You start by choosing the tools that you want to connect and your accounts. The first time you do this, you have to go through an authorization process, but I'll have a link in the description below showing you how to do that. And then you choose the table you want to connect from ServiceNow as well as the sheet from Smartsheet. So both of my accounts have already been connected to each tool, so I just have to choose the sheets I plan on syncing. In this case, it's my dispatch tasks 2024, and I'll connect it to my incidents table in ServiceNow. And then you'll watch as I configure just a few more steps and send records straight into Smartsheet from ServiceNow. In this step, I'm just setting a flow direction between my tools. So you can imagine that with this setup, I'll be sending records from ServiceNow into Smartsheet so that rows will appear with all of their fields synced to ServiceNow. If I'd chosen either of the other two directions, I could also have my rows in Smartsheet create new records in ServiceNow. For this use case though, I'm only sending information one way, but as you'll see, we'll still have two-way updates configured later on. So next, I'm setting rules that determine which records will become rows in Smartsheet or not. So I'll start by choosing a category. So that's a choice field in ServiceNow. And I'll tell Unito that I only want to sync, let's say, electrical tasks from ServiceNow to Smartsheet. So in order for that record type to sync over to Smartsheet, it must have that category highlighted. Here, I'll just choose to map automatically. Unito will attempt to configure my fields for me to link up fields that are similar. It's a way of starting with a pre-built template. And then you can just click on Add Mapping to add new pairs of fields. And this sets the relationship between your fields in ServiceNow and your fields in Smartsheet. For example, if I've got a customer name in Smartsheet, my field in ServiceNow is caller. So I'm telling Unito that these are the same. So I'll just skip ahead to show you what my completed set of field mappings looks like. Okay, so now you can see that I've added around a dozen fields with different sync directions indicated. Anytime you see two arrows, that indicates a two-way sync, so changes to either tool will affect the other. An arrow going in a single direction indicates one-way updates. So in this case, changes to my address, caller, zip code, or city fields in ServiceNow will update my team in Smartsheet, but not the other way around. So my team in Smartsheet can still edit those fields, but it won't impact the original ServiceNow record. One more thing, any set of fields with a gear icon indicates fields with additional options that you can configure. So in this case, I'm setting statuses between ServiceNow and Smartsheet so that as my statuses change in one tool or the other, Unito knows how to link them to the same fields in the other tool, even if they're named differently. And as you can see here, I've grouped a couple of options by clicking on the plus sign. So that tells Unito that even though two fields might have similar names, they are essentially the same or serve the same purpose. So in this case, my closed or resolved field in ServiceNow is the equivalent to the complete status in Smartsheet. And you can also order these however you like. Just be aware that the first value that you select will be the one that Unito will automatically defer to. So I've switched them around now so you can see that if a Smartsheet task is set to complete, it will be marked as resolved in Unito. And closed will only be used if I choose to set it manually, but it won't change the status in Smartsheet. So I'll go ahead and close this up, then confirm. And now all that's left to do is launch the flow. I'll click this button here, and then we'll look at the record I created in ServiceNow on the left, and you can see Smartsheet on the right. I'm just going to remove some formatting here just to make it a little bit cleaner. So now we're just waiting for the incident to appear in Smartsheet in the first row. You can see all the details on the left that we want to see in Smartsheet. Okay, and there it is. So I'll just open that up. Now you can see the two side by side. All of the fields that I input into ServiceNow have now appeared in Smartsheet. Any changes I make will update in the other in real time. So I can just close that up. And that's how you can sync ServiceNow incidents to Smartsheet rows. Thanks for watching.